A great morning to all the dignitaries and participants who have joined here for this AICT Training and Learning Academy's Faculty Development Program on Electric Vehicle Challenges and Opportunities in Future India, organized by the Department of Mechanical Engineering, RMK College of Engineering and Technology, Chennai. We welcome you all for this Day 2 Atal FDP program. And we have here our special eminent speaker, Dr. Ashok G. Matani, sir. And it's my pleasure to introduce Dr. Ashok G. Matani, sir, to all the participants here. He's working as a professor in Mechanical Engineering Department at Government College of Engineering, Jalgaon, Maharashtra. And he has completed his PhD in Mechanical Engineering and MBA in Marketing. And he has overall experience of 32 years in academic research, administrative and industries. He presented more than 110 papers, research and technical papers in seminars, conferences organized in the Indian Institute of Technology and National Institute of Technology, especially published more than 26 papers in Scopus Index journals. And Dr. Ashok G. Matani, sir, has H index of 14 and I10 index of 21, with overall citations of 470. His area of interest is energy conservation, industrial engineering, productivity, industrial management, operations management, entrepreneurship, water conservation, and environment. He guided 3 PhD scholars and awarded a PhD degree from Sandgach Baba Amravati University and 1 PhD scholar research in progress under his guidance. His 5 patents have been accepted for publication on Indian Patent Office Mumbai website. He acted as a reviewer and editorial board member of Scopus Index Journal. He delivered 40 keynote and invited lectures in various conferences, seminars organized in IITs, NITs, and Institute of National Importance, and worked as a session chair in 51 conferences, seminars organized in IITs, NITs, and Institute of National Importance, and delivered more than 84 expert lectures in various STTPs, FDPs, sponsored by AICT, ISTE, TEQIP, the Government of Maharashtra, Government of India schemes. And his 9 papers awarded as the best papers in conferences, seminars organized in IITs, NITs, and Institute of National Importance. And it's my pleasure to welcome you, sir, in the session. And I request Dr. Ashok G. Matani, sir, to discuss his presentation on latest innovations in electric vehicle technology. Please, sir.
Thank you for kind introduction. Good morning to all of you. I am pleased to see the participant. Just the clock is going 10.00 and nearly 63 participants, now 68 participants have reported. This indicates that the participants are quite active and they are interested. It is a pleasure for me and a pleasure and a plus appreciation to organizers in which the participants are so much well in advance and they are ready to listen and learn something. That is very good thing. And I like these participants. Of course, majority of these participants might be more knowledgeable in their specialized area, but wherever they will be sharing their experiences or some suggestions, welcome in the meantime also. Okay. So my topic for discussion here is, latest innovations in electrical vehicles technology. Now here we are finding that nowadays the electric car consists of energy storage device powering one electric traction motor which spins wheels via transmission. Now this first electric car or electric vehicle were invented in 19th century. Now this has lost the battle up to the IC engines, unable to compete with the energy density of gasoline. And now Honorable Shri Nitinji Gadkari sir, Honorable Minister of Surface Transport, he has declared that by next 5 years, all petrol or gasoline run vehicles will be stopped and only IC, means that these vehicles will be running only on electric means. Means this Government of India initiative is the latest, 3 days back he has announced, and I read that in newspaper, ki now Government of India is working to isolate these IC engines and totally dependent on electrical cars now. Of course, at present, this is a nascent stage, at an initial stage in India, but definitely it is gaining momentum. And now new manufacturers are coming in electric vehicles. And recently, last week government of Maharashtra has declared electric vehicle policy 4-5 days back, and they have offered incentives, some tax benefits, even concessions in road and this vehicle registration, plus new this charging stations they will be creating. This is good thing, and some I will be explaining the different states the developments in that. But latest these 3-4 days back developments I have highlighted here. Now over 100 years later, the lithium ion battery is now enabling their meteoric rise as a solution for reducing local emissions and greenhouse gases, because this is one of the challenge. Even during this COVID, this has been the related with environmental pollution, because COVID, it is causing the lungs affection, lungs functioning, and these lungs air pollution, they are causing these lungs cancer or lungs means malfunctioning, and these are the main culprit of air pollution in India, and particularly in metros where traffic congestion is there. In Delhi and Mumbai, we can imagine and see the news channels reports ki how these long rows of vehicles are on the roads, and this is the problem for asthma and other related lungs related diseases, and this is related with corona virus, and this is one of the factor for more affection of these corona patients in metros. So these electric vehicles now include these cars, transit buses, trucks of all sizes, and even rig big tractor trailers that are the least at least partially powered by electricity. Now these vehicles, electrical vehicles, fall into three main categories. First one is battery electric vehicles, which are powered by electricity stored in battery pack. Then plug-in hybrids, this combines a gasoline or diesel engine with electric motor and large rechargeable battery. And fuel cell vehicles, these split electrons from hydrogen molecules to produce electricity to run the motor. Now this is the some of the sketches or the diagrams or how these are working. First one is that is hybrid car, that is combination of gasoline and electric motors, no plug-in there. Second one sketch we are our car sample we are finding here, plug-in hybrid, in which this is mainly powered by electric motor and battery. Now car will tap into gas tank when the battery runs out. And third is fully electric car, solely powered by battery, plug-in to charge the battery. Now this, of course, in India, this is the one of the challenge ki this plugging or this recharge stations are comparatively less, and this is the hurdle in a more popularity, but government of India is working on that, and other state governments, they are working on that. Definitely it is gaining now momentum. Even in my city Amravati and Jalgaon, where I am belonging, I am seeing some electric scooters running on the roads, and they are functioning effectively. The people are now attracted towards this, adopting this. Now these categories of electric vehicles, and this electric vehicle market based on components, vehicle type, vehicle class, top speed, vehicle drive type, EV charging points, V2G propulsion and region. Now based on the components, these are classified according to the components which are parts of this vehicle, that is battery cells and packs, then onboard charge, motor, reducer, fuel stack, power control unit, battery management system, fuel processor, power conditioner, air compressor and humidifier. Now based on the vehicle, whether it is passenger car or it is commercial, just like we are finding that trucks luggage or other purposes nowadays, even for medicals and corona medicines, these are also used. Even the drones are used for transportation of these corona drugs and all other pharmaceutical equipments and pharmaceutical these medicines in the metros because of traffic congestion. And this is also one of the aspects for us. Now based on the vehicle class, whether it is mid-price or luxury, because some people require, they will be requiring some luxury cars, luxury vehicles, and hence according to their choice, these manufacturers, they are manufacturing the cars. Then based on the top speed, there are two types, that is less than 125 miles per hour, and second type is more than 125 miles per hour. Now based on vehicle drive type, whether it is front wheel drive, rear wheel drive or all wheel drive. Then based on in electric vehicle charging point, that is normal charging or supercharging. And based on electrical vehicle to grid technology, this is V2B or V2G. That is V2B means vehicle to building, and V2H is vehicle to home. And V2G is vehicle grid to grid technology, also known as car to grid. And V2V, it is vehicle to vehicle. And V2X, that is vehicle to everything. Technology emphasizes availability and accessibility with a smaller size, lighter weight, and simpler installation process. Because one of the challenges is the car, its weight should be comparatively less. Then only its mileage will be more, its speed will be more. So based on propulsion, is battery electric vehicles are there, then PHV, that is plug-in hybrid electrical vehicles, use batteries to power electric motor and another fuel such as gasoline to power an internal combustion engine. And this fuel cell electric car, that is hydrogen fuel cell electric car, this is also one of the classification based on this propulsion. So based on the region, road world, we are having Asia Pacific, in which in Asia Pacific, major four countries are there: China, India, Japan, and North Korea. And North America, US and Canada, and Europe, we are finding majority of the countries, they are adopting this technology, in which France, Germany, UK, Netherlands, Switzerland, Australia, Norway, Spain, Denmark, and Sweden. So this is one of the type in which this assembly of this electric vehicle is there, in which we are finding that is battery system of, it is more than 600 kg in the under body, and another that is interior with large displays. And here we are finding that sensors and cameras, and a new design that is chassis with integrated e-meters and electric brakes and steering. And this nano designs are there for lights weighting, because the weight of the vehicle is the prime importance here, because if it is light vehicle, then its mileage will be more, and moreover, it will be running for more time, so that we can have less time for recharging. Because at a stretch, at present, these luxury buses, what we call, these are running at a stretch 500 kilometers. After 500 kilometers, we have to recharge that. So this is the sketch where we are finding that its assembly, how this is made there. Now here we are finding these are EV charging, then IC CPD die sensors are there, then sensors, micro sensors are there, new broadband architecture is there, then passenger occupant detection system is there, then brake by wire is there, then EPS electric power assisted steering is there, rotor stator system, then double clutch gear sensor, EGR gas vest, exhaust gas recirculation, just what we call that. This gas, then EMI suppression, and DSGS injection is there. So these are the components of one of the electric car. So here, that simple, in the simplest form, that is all electric vehicle, that is electric traction motor is there, then power electronics controllers are there, DC-DC converter, then thermal system cooling, then your traction battery pack, then charge point is there, transmission, onboard charger, and battery, that is auxiliary. Again, same battery sketch is coming. Now, why we should have electric vehicles, or what is the significance, or what is the use of that? Now, these major reason for introduction or innovation of these vehicles is these are saving the climate, because the largest source of climate pollution in the US and in throughout world, it is the air pollution, that is transportation. And this is the main culprit, because governments, they have to offer the transportation systems, transportation media, so that people should commute, they should travel with minimum time, with comfort. And with this, some drawbacks of this air pollution are there. They are causing this gasoline power stations, they are causing this air pollution. Hence, this resulted in introduction of these electric vehicles. To solve this climate crisis, we need to make the vehicles on roads as clean as possible. Now, emissions from cars and trucks are not only bad for our planet, they are also bad for our health. Because this is the, in metros, this is even, I have seen on GNews and ABP news channel last year, in which they have made one sample of two lungs outside their hospitals, just to aware the awareness of how air pollution is affecting the lungs functioning. And they have made some artificial lungs, they have exposed these to air direct exposure to air. And in that, they have seen that within 1 week, these lungs, their color become dark. Dark gray they become, because they were affected by this air pollution and their functioning was also affected. Hence, they are, this Sir Gangaram Hospital. Yes, I am audible, no? Yes, okay, everything, no problem in that? Sir?
No, sir.
Okay, please. And they hope, I have seen that picture of that news channel reports last year, in which these lungs, they were colored, their color was dark because it was affected the lungs. And throughout the world, there is no at present remedy for lungs replacement. We are liver transplant, are there, other eye transplants are there, other organism of the human body are there, but up till now, no lungs transplant is possible at present in medical history. And this is the critical for us to make that, at least provide that clean air in the metros. But since considering that traffic intensity and plus this pollution of airs, so this is resulting in that, and they are now trying working on that, so that, and this is resulted in introduction of electric vehicles. Now, air pollutants from gasoline and diesel power vehicles cause asthma, bronchitis, cancer, and premature deaths. Also, this is the one of these factors. These 4 or 5 diseases, these are very much fatal for human life. So this long-term health impacts of localized air pollution last for lifetime, because we cannot clean these lungs. Once it is inside the lungs, we cannot clean that. That is the main drawback for that. With the effects borne out in asthma attacks, lung damage, and heart conditions. These electric vehicles have a small carbon footprint than gasoline power cars, no matter where your electricity comes from. Because even though at present this electricity from where we are charging this, of course, 70% of the power generation in India is from thermal power stations. Renewable are now coming. Solar and wind powers are now coming, but their contribution is totally nearly 29 to 30%. Remaining 70% is still from thermal power stations. Of course, that is also whatever we will be using that for charging and plugging, definitely it is from thermal power, but at a source, these are controlled with the this ESP and other emittent collectors in thermal power stations, and they have come to means controlling condition in thermal power stations. Air pollution from these chimneys, they have controlled that, and ash and air pollution. Now, because electric vehicles are more efficient in converting electric energy to power cars and trucks, electricity across the board is cleaner and cheaper as fuel for vehicles, even when that electricity comes from the dirty grid. No problem in that. At present, even this is somewhat costlier, but definitely when more charging stations will be there, plugging stations will be there, just like at petrol pumps, we are finding. So now at every kilometer in city or in on express highways, every 5 to 7 kilometers, we are finding petrol pumps. Definitely these charging stations will be coming. Government of India is working on that. And Honorable Shri Nitin Gadkari sir has declared within 5 years, all automobile manufacturers, they have to manufacture electric vehicles only. Gasoline power, they will be, gradually they will be close. And after 5 years, this will be totally closure of these IC engines, and definitely all will be electric vehicles. Now, in the manufacturing process, electric vehicles will produce more global warming emission than average gasoline vehicles, because electric cars, large lithium ion batteries require a lot of materials and energy to build. This is one of the drawbacks for that, but definitely new developments are going on in lithium ion battery and nanotechnology, they are going on, and definitely it is coming to under working means controllable conditions. This manufacturing a mid-side electric car with 84 mileage range results in 15% more emissions. Means 84 miles are we can convert in kilometers, then it is coming nearly 200 kilometers. So this is only 15% emissions more. Now the average electric car on the road has the same greenhouse emissions as a car getting 88 miles per gallon. which is far greater than the average new gasoline-powered car, that is 31 miles per gallon, or truck, that is 21 miles per gallon, according to analysis by the Union of Concerned Scientists. They have come to analysis in that. This is there. The electrical vehicles can be charged at home, at work, anywhere. Once we are in office, we can just plug in. Of course, in India, it is at present, it is not. But in other countries, developed countries, this is there. Even just you park in your vehicle in this parking area and plug in, and you work in your office. And when it is fully charged, then you will be getting one message that this is fully charged, and you can take that vehicle for your purpose. So this is in developed countries, it is there. This ASD electric vehicles hit the market and are used broadly in new recharging solutions, including adding more public charging locations in shopping centers, just like DMarts and these supermarkets we are finding. This will be there. And then parking garages, then workshop, workplaces where we are working or we are going for some other official work, then we can recharge that during that our meeting time. This will be required for people and business without the same access at home. Now, planning now by states and utilities to build infrastructure for charging vehicles will go a long way. The utilities in California are investing more than $1 billion to build the charging infrastructure necessary for electric cars, trucks, and buses throughout the states. Of course, in the US and other countries, there the public is quite alert, and they are quality conscious, hence these are working on that. Because once we are introducing these vehicles, then we have to provide after-sales service also. So this is one of the plus factor, so that people, if they are purchasing the vehicles and if the charging stations or maintenance are not there, then definitely they will be discouraged. Hence, this is also one of the quality aspects in that, and encouraging these incentives. These kinds of infrastructure investments are important for public transport agencies, business people who want to purchase electrical but are unable to install a charging at home. Probably at home they will not be affording that, or because of some location disadvantage or some family problems or some child, they might be touching these charging stations because they will be playing. They are not knowing how much current is there. Then that is the reason some people, they are not preparing at home, but they are preparing at offices and parking stations. And moreover, charging at parking places or offices, this means they will not be any infrastructure on their own. Just they will be paying the charges for this charging time. Okay, how much they have charged that for 5 hours, 6 hours, 4 hours. Buses are the workhorse of our transit system, providing affordable transportation to anyone and everywhere. They are the cornerstone of daily life in many cities, making them an important step for getting big electric market vehicles into the broader transportation market. Because even Government of India is also working on that MRIS, Mass Rapid Transport System, so that people should share the vehicles in one. Everybody, those who are going in office, they are at present using their own two-wheelers or four-wheelers. Government is working so that public should use common vehicles, so that less pollution will be there. Of course, it is loss for government, because in that way, some less number of cars and scooters or two-wheelers will be sold. But another aspect is keep this, everybody, if he is using his own vehicle, then pollution is also plus the gasoline or petrol and diesel, which we are using, that is also coming from Gulf countries. 70% of this petroleum is from importing, and we are also investing on that forex, which results in foreign forex reserves for us. And this is also one of the topic for, if we are having less deposit of forex, then it is not good signal of economy. We should have more number of dollars of foreign reserves, and only economy is powerful, what we call that. So hence government is working on encouraging this common transportation system, just like metros or these buses, 16 seater buses, 40 seater buses, so that people should share that buses. Now, there is vast potential in that. This global electric market is projected to grow from 4093 at present it is, and government are this, its projected growth is by to next 7-8 years, it will be going to 34,756 had compounded average growth rate of 26.8%. Just imagine what is the potential in that. Because government, all governments are working on that. State governments in India, majority of the state governments have now implemented their electric vehicle policy. And they are encouraging that. They are providing some services, some incentives. So all governments are working on that throughout the world. It is there. And hence we are finding that this huge potential is there. Means 4093,000 to it is going to 34,756,000 units by next 9 years. These factors such as growing demand for low emission commuting and governments supporting long range and zero emission vehicles through subsidies and tax rebates, they have compelled the manufacturers to provide electric vehicles around the world. This has led to growing demand for electric vehicles in the market. Now, countries around the world have set up targets for emission reductions according to their own capacity, because when there is conferences or meetings at world level, then all country heads, they are promising they will be reducing their pollution to their some percentage. All promise there, but majority of the governments, they are finding difficult to fulfill their promises because of some conditions which are beyond their control. Yes. Vehicles we are using to minimize this gasoline or petrol and diesel, but people are, all drivers are not aware of that. So hence, this is the topic for state governments. Of course, in India, emission norms and traffic norms are so stringent and so strong and powerful, in which I am telling just one example, in which my friends, he has traveled from Nagpur to Amravati and he has just crossed the speed limit of express highway. And in next 10 minutes, he got one message, alert message on his mobile, ki you have crossed that limit, speed limit, and 2000, he has paid this penalty. Means that these norms are strong in Maharashtra, in India. Traffic norms are strong, powerful. And he got that with one warning. If you make this repeat again, your driver, this driving license will be seized. So this is in Maharashtra, in Nagpur, that is in Vidarbha, from where I am belonging. Means these traffic norms are, traffic rules are working. But all drivers are not aware of that. Hence, even some drivers, they are thinking we will pay that money, but they will be violating the traffic norms. Even express highway, these drones are now used for Mumbai Pune Express Highway, that is six-way lane. Even government of India, last 10 days back, I have seen one news channel in which these now lidar sensors are used for express highway survey, so that minimum distance can be identified. And these lidars and drone surveys, they are now used for making this, because government is working on that. And this Samruddhi Express Highway, it is the most ambitious project of government of India, Ministry of Surface Transport, and they are working on that. And in that, targeting the speed up to 50 kilometers per hour of the cars on that express highway. This is so, means Nagpur to Mumbai within 8 hours. Imagine how much, at present it is taking 16 hours. Means within 50% time will be reduced. Now, these are the some of the market dynamics or the trends, the why electric vehicles are encouraged, or what can be the factors for which we can increase the its potential percentage. Now, these are the drivers or strengths. The first is the reducing the cost of EV batteries, because this is the more, one of the most cost component is the one of the percentage which is costing that vehicle. Now, due to technological advancements and the production of electric vehicle batteries on mass scale in large volumes, this cost of batteries is now decreasing. This has led to decrease in cost of vehicles, as batteries are one of the most expensive parts. And the price in 10 years back, its price of electric vehicles was around US$1,100 per kVH. But now it has come down, and this has come to US$100 per kVH. In China, and in America, it has come to US$137 per kVH. Means here we are finding that is from 1100 to 137. It's nearly is 12-13%. It is means coming means so drastic reduction in cost of the vehicles battery. So this is there. Even again, this will be going on reducing the cost, because when more number of production units will be installed, battery charging batteries will be more manufactured, more charging stations will be installed, then again its cost will be coming down, because mass scale production will be there. This is because of reducing the manufacturing cost of these batteries, reduced cathode material prices and greater volumes of production. So these prices of electric vehicles are expected to fall to around, this will be coming, and it is targeted at again $60 per kVA by 8 years, next 8 years, which will greatly reduce the price of EV, making them cheaper than conventional IC vehicles. Even now we are finding in India, at least in Maharashtra, the cost of petrol per liter, it is going nearly 110 rupees per liter, and diesel it is going nearly 98 rupees per liter. And imagine what can be the cost. Hence government is working on that, and definitely we are finding that the cost of batteries, it is reducing day by day because of large scale production. Now, the restraints are weaknesses. This is the SWOT analysis of these batteries or electric vehicles. This is the vehicles weaknesses are there. Some of the weaknesses that there is low number of EV charging stations, and this is the one of the drawback, most disadvantages, less number of charging stations are there. This makes the possibility of public EV charging less, thereby reducing demand for vehicles. Although many countries are working on developing EV charging infrastructure, they won't be able to develop appropriate number of charging except in some states. Definitely, this raw material is also not available. Even now, new nanotechnology aspects, lithium ion batteries, they are working on that. And now they are somehow coming to that. Even research R&D on this nanotechnology is most promising, giving promising results in that, because if its weight is less, battery, the weight of battery is less, then its mileage will be more and it will run more mileage, but with good speed. So this is one of these, at present this is one of the drawback, but definitely it is going that. Even Netherlands have the highest EV charging density per 100 kilometers. So Netherlands have adopted that. And opportunities, that is government's initiative pertaining to EVs, that is countries throughout the world have set up targets of around 2050 to reduce vehicle emissions, because by next 28 years, these governments, they are also targeting to reduce that air pollution, at least air pollution. So they are working on that, but this opportunity is there. They have started promoting the development and sales of EVs and related charging infrastructure. This, the US government invested $5 billion in 2017 to promote electric vehicles such as charging stations. These several governments are providing various kinds of incentives such as low to zero registration fees and exemptions from import tax, purchase tax and road tax. Even government of India, they have made new developments. Last fortnight, I have read in newspapers and on news channels, in which government of India, Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi sir, has declared that vehicle policy, ki those who are vehicles which are outdated or not functioning effectively are having more than 15 years age, these vehicles just take one certificate from RTO. If this is not functioning and it is coming under a scrap category, and produce that certificate and go to any automobile dealer or seller and purchase new vehicle, and these registration charges and road tax, they are exempted by Government of India. So this is the new development in Government of India policy, in which this providing that incentives to these IC engines which are isolated, even a National Green Tribunal in Delhi, which is having powers of as good as Honorable Supreme Court. They are providing their assistance and encouraging that these vehicles in Delhi, they should not function on the roads. Diesel vehicles which are more than 10 years old, and petrol vehicles, four wheelers particularly, which are 15 years old, they are banned in metros. National Green Tribunal, they have made that 2 years back, that policy. and they are working on that, because they are observing that when its life is more than it's estimated and these engine characteristics are violated and it is not giving that optimum functioning, and hence more pollution than noise vibrations are also there in IC engines. So hence governments are working on that incentives. Even a majority of the state governments, they have now provided that incentives for road tax, no any registration tax will be there, even no any driving license is required for that. Even any ladies or any students above 18 years, they can use that electric vehicles. And so this is one of the incentives in which exemption from import tax, purchase tax, road tax. So these are functioning in India. In almost majority of the state governments, they have framed that electric vehicle policy and they are offering these exemptions. So this is one of the opportunity for this increasing these electric vehicles. Then countries such as Norway and Germany are investing in significantly in promoting sales. They are taking the lead role in that, Norway and Germany. And here we are finding Europe, European countries, they are much ahead as compared to other countries in the world. Hence, due to large incentives and subsidies in Europe, a high growth rate in sale of vehicles is observed. And this has led to growth in demand of components and equipments associated with EV charging operations, such as charging cables, connectors, adapters, and portable chargers. As a part of partnership between US Departments of Energy and Transportation, this 2020 vision for national fast charging network is expected to be developed, with potential longer term innovations, which include up to 350 kV of direct current fast charging. Even stringent CO2 emission norms have increased the demand for electric vehicles, because those who are violating are there is increasing carbon footprint and definitely they are penalized. The governments are investing significantly in providing incentives and subsidies to encourage sales of EVs. These steps taken by governments around the world have increased the demand for EVs in the coming decades. Now, some challenges are there, or threats are there. This threat or that challenge is insufficient standardization of EV charging infrastructure. This is the main topic. These factors such as growth of electric vehicle market and variation in charging loads have emphasized the need for the standardization of electric vehicle charging stations. Certain EV charging stations may be compatible with certain type of voltage. Take example, AC charging stations provide voltage of 120 volts through level 1 charging and 2024 watts AC through level 2 charging station. Of course, this is the condition of European and American countries. In India, we are having 230 volts, but this is the case of these examples are from European and American countries. And on the other hand, DC charging stations provide fast charging through 480 volt AC. So, governments need to standardize charging infrastructure for the development of favorable ecosystem and increase in sales of EVs. Even different countries, they have made standards for fast charging. Japan has used in that, they are using that CHAdeMO. In Europe, US and Korea, they use CCS and China uses GBT. So these are these. They are charging standards and they are using that. These are, they have taken lead in that. The Indian government has mandated the installation of both CHAdeMO and CCS methods. At present, we are of course not having that much standard system in EV systems, but the throughout world, which is popular, the government of India, they have made these two standards, CHAdeMO and CCS methods. Through this mandate, increase the installation cost of charging stations, and government change the guidelines and allow charging stations develop to choose the method they prefer. So after some time, government give some preference, you can charge at any standard method, but it should be standards. This US-based electrical market Tesla uses high performance superchargers that are unique to Tesla and cannot be used for other EVs. The lack of standardization across countries may interrupt the installation of charging stations and hamper the growth of charging market. Now, this Asia Pacific market is the main potential market, being the largest share by next 7 to 8 years. This Asia Pacific EV market is led by countries like China, Japan, and South Korea. And China is producing the largest number of EV producers and has a dominance in the EV market in this region, Asia Pacific region. The government has taken in steps, including subsidy for buyers compulsory laws by which all vehicles need to manufacture EV for number of vehicles manufactured, large support to installation of EV charging points across major cities and regulations against excessive polluting vehicles. This is strict stringent norms in China, and in China they are making that norms very powerful norms are there, and penalties and there is no compromise there. So this is the one of these advantage for China, and this has become the leader in Asia Pacific. And Japan and Korea, South Korea have been growing this their market. These governments have supported EV demand growth by installing EV charging stations, making emission norms, setting up deadlines for shifting to full or hybrid EV from IC vehicles. Even the government of India now have made in next 5 years all IC, means internal combustion engines, will be replaced by electric vehicles. The same, almost a majority of the governments throughout the world, they are working on that, and they are making some policies, incentives for that, so that people should attract and work on that. And one good thing for us is, since we are engineers and majority of the participants are teachers, faculty, and we are having young minds of M.Tech and R.B.Tech and PhD in engineering, almost all branch of engineering. And we can attract and we can guide our students so that they will be working on their R&D projects, R&D projects and seminars on these topics. Definitely, we are having, our intellect is quite remarkable. Indians are valued in US and other developed countries with full respect, because we Indians are known for our honesty, sincerity, intelligence and hardworking. Just we have to guide our students that they should take these topics, they should work on these electric vehicles models, make some models, some have some prototypes, some experimentation, or whatever drawbacks, whatever results are coming. Of course, some of in initial stages this will be discouraging, no problem in that. But after that, after analysis, we can guide them and we can help that so that we can submit that patents on that. Nowadays, I am finding majority of the patents are filed on this new technology, EV technology, because it is a new, nascent, and no competition, no any threat of any plagiarism or any repetition of the work. Hence, patents are easily accepted, and since it is promising, giving promising results, hence we should encourage our students, our researchers, even those who are young teachers and doing their PhD work, they can work on these topics. Since we are having quite good infrastructure in some of the laboratories, or even RI and other government of India organizations are have MOU with electrical or these automobile manufacturers. Now these electric vehicle manufacturers, they will be coming, they are working in India. Some of these I will be highlighting in next slides, in which we should have MOU with them, do research work on that, and means make in India concept. At present, we are importing that technology, but we can work on that. And even a majority of the engineers, those working in US and other developed countries, they are Indians. So they will be coming for this. And this is the potential market in the next 7 to 8 years. Now, some technology advancements in this current electric car are there. That is, these are becoming less expensive, at the same time becoming more affordable. These production costs are coming down, and use of lithium-ion batteries have increased nowadays. This nanotechnology is working on this. Vehicles when looking such as Nissan Leaf has remote access to vehicle from smartphone, just like we are having our sensors in our car. The same this Nissan Leaf that is having in electric vehicles also. We can start car before we are in it. Just like we have seen one advertisements of air conditioners in which one executive is starting from home, and he is just starting with remote his air conditioner, and within 5-7 minutes he is arriving at his home, and in the meantime room is cool. He's from his office, he is having remote control for AC. Same is here with remote control for electric vehicle. When we are in office and we can just, even we those who cannot wait for 5-7 minutes, and they can through remote they can start that. Even along with this change in temperature in car from outside and give charging information to that seconds. These features are used to come with vehicles as extra additions are now this new, that is the luxury aspect of that. Of course, this voice recognition are being able to find car remotely in parking is also one of the example in which nowadays even these cars, they will be identifying our voice or our face or our fingers. so that nobody should steal our car or take away car. Only genuine car owner, they will be using that or driving that vehicle, because now that the car theft cases are also going on, or these duplicate keys, they are used by some of these thieves, and they are taking away these cars. But now this new concept are also coming in these electric vehicles, in which only voice recognition, after that it will be starts. Even one of my students, he is 5 years back, he has done made one project in which this they have made sensors in that, and put all electronic and instrumentation parts inside, in which if driver is in drunken stage, its steering is locked. And I have worked on that. We have submitted that project to IIT Kharagpur, IIT Mumbai, and both 3-4 papers we have presented there on this technology, and we have been appreciated by this. And that student, which he has made that, now he is collector. He has passed. He was a GATE qualified, and after that GATE, he go to Delhi for 2 years. He has done preparation of IAS, and now he has become collector. Means imagine ki these students are engineers, they are working on that, and he has now become collector. Means it is good thing for me also ki our students are now coming to this. Of course, collector, majority of the part is administration, but engineering aspects are also coming to this nowadays, considering this security and safety aspects in, and even IoT applications in majority of the parts. Even now online classes are going on, online meetings are going on. This will be, means, a useful part there, because no any knowledge is wasted, and we require multi-skilling nowadays. Even though I am from mechanical, you are from civil, electrical, electronics. Now this blending of this blending of these skills is now desired. We should have some, at least some fundamental knowledge of working of these equipment. We are having good equipments, cars and ACs, but we are not able to operate that. This should not happen. We should be operating that in comfortable modes. Now many of the interior characteristics are simplified in these vehicles to focus on exceptional technology. Even using a smartphone for a variety of things throughout the car makes it easier to feel connected to the machine. Now these advancements in vehicle battery, so in this the gradual decline in electrical battery cost has helped to make the vehicles themselves more affordable. So this is the range of that. The average cost of battery set down from $1,000 per kVh to roughly 2 to 7 per kVh nowadays. Means nearly to $2 to $7 per kVh. That this capacity of this electric vehicle is known by kVh. So this has slashed to nearly 1/5. Means from 1,000 11 years back, now at present it is 2 to 7. Of course, the day by day it will be decreasing. This results in decrease, drastic reduction in overall cost associated with vehicle. And these batteries themselves have become more efficient. The new development is key, is cost is less, and plus these are becoming more efficient, giving more, means more mileage or more time. At present, these electric buses, IIT stage, they are charged for 500 kilometers distance. Of course, the new developments, when this will be charged for 700 kilometers, 800 kilometers, nanotechnology is working on that. To my knowledge, this this is the 500 kilometers means per charging, what we call that. At this stage, 500 kilometers, it is working without any middle recharging at any place. So, and even this most means this lithium ion batteries, these are the main components, and majority of these batteries are made on this. Even Tesla have continued to invest heavily in this due to high recharge capacity of these batteries. Even these lithium-ion batteries made by researchers at Stanford have made a protective nano layer that expands the battery's increasing temperatures. With these advancements, there are many hurdles that electric vehicles must overcome. Now, this battery technology, that is the electronic systems that keep EV working and safe, and electric motor efficiency were limiting factors in the 20th century, but now continuous innovations in each of these technologies, such as invention of lithium ion in the 90s, have paved the way for profound rise in EV manufacturing and consumer adoption. Now, customers or the users, what they expect or what they, why they prefer, or what are their expectations. That is the travel range, charge capacity, safety ratings, efficiency, performance, aesthetics, and affordability. Because affordability means within cost calculations, what we call that. Now, charging station availability, that is the long the infrastructure been for ownership. New materials like silicon carbide have enabled revolution in legacy silicon technologies. Even high voltage current protection, signal isolation, and battery management technologies are also motivational factor for EV performance. Now, this future of electric vehicles, how it can be or what will be there? We can expect new electric vehicles to enter the market, building on innovations made by Tesla and other, because these are the leading at present leaders, market leaders in electric vehicle market. That is Tesla, then BYD, BAIC, Nissan, BMW, and Volkswagen. Even legislative advancements in Europe, ever-increasing demand in Asia, and increased awareness of fossil fuels environmental impacts will ensure the technology continue to grow. So these are the main motivational factors where we can be seeing that bright future of electrical vehicles. Here are the few industries to watch for EV innovation. That is racing, means consumer road vehicles are the only ones that going electric. Formula One, pinnacle of automobile racing. This racing is also one of the factor. Motorcycles. So these are already gearing towards shift towards electric motorcycles. At present, we are having electrical scooters, but motorcycles are also now made. Even with this Zero, the motorcycle world's version of Tesla, it is brand name of that, is becoming known as top motorcycle manufacturer. Then electric semi-trucks, this Nikola, Rivian, Tesla, Daimler, and Volvo, they are working on this road-based transportation industry. And this boating, even now electric boats are also working on that model. And airplanes, probably we'll be seeing that. Of course, these models are going on and at experimental stage. I also read in newspapers that now electric planes, they will be, light up electrical aeroplanes will be, is possible now. At present, they are working on this aviation turbine fuel or some of the planes for solar panels, but these passenger planes, they are not on solar. They are totally on aviation turbine fuel, but now new technology, this electrical planes, they will be, now we will be seeing that aeroplanes which running on this electric vehicle technology. In this year, in April, Toyota launched the new LS and Mirai models in Japan with advanced driving assist technology. And this BYD launched 4 new electric vehicle models equipped with blade batteries in Chongqing. This is the area. This new vehicle models, Tang EV, Qi Plus EV, Song Plus EV, and E21, these are the names of models with advanced battery safety features. In even Volkswagen unveiled that 7-seater EV ID.6 Cross and ID.6X produced along with FA and SA in China. These vehicles will be sold in China only because they have made some to be specific to China, but definitely they will be coming out of China when they will be having some good results. It comes in 2 battery versions, that is 58 kVH and 77. Of course, these are the two-wheelers which are having that much limited 58 kVH and 77 in 4 powertrain configurations. In March this year, Volvo showcased its new C40 Recharge model. This vehicle is recharged as pure electric car and has features similar to its XC model last, which made that some refinement has made that. And in December last, Nissan announced that 2021 Leaf model in US. This vehicle comes with choice of battery between 40 kVh to 62 kVh, and mileage range is between 149 miles and 2 to 6 miles per charge. So, means this, they have made 2 models in that. And 2 years back, BYD launched its Hang, which comes with blade battery and is available in BEV and PHEV versions. Then two battery options, that is 65 kVH option for 315 miles and 77 kVH option for 342 miles range. So this is, they have made that BYD. And its PHEV comes with 13 kVH battery and 2.0 liters gasoline engine and 180 kVH electric motor. In March last year, BMW launched the second generation 33E and 330EX drive in the North American market. This vehicle with 12 kVH battery and all electric range up to 20 to 22 miles. Of course, its range is small, but they have made that for residents and even for college students. In November 2019, BYD launched its E3 electric sedan in China. It comes with two battery options, 35.2 kVH and 47.3 kVH, and single 70 kV electric motor. The vehicle has a range of around 252 miles. 2 years back, Hyundai Group showcased its new plug-in electric version with increased capacity of 38.3 kVH. That is from 28. Previously, it was 28, and they have now made that 38.3 kVH in larger range. Now, this electric vehicle market is dominated by established players such as Tesla of US, BYD of China, Volkswagen Germany, then BMW Group Germany, and Nissan Motors Japan. These are only the five market leaders are key players in this electric vehicle. The market ranging have been derived by considering certain percentage of segmental revenue. These companies are also offering extensive products and solutions, and they have strong distribution networks. In that countries, they are having that strong network. In India, we are at present on an expansion stage. So we'll be expecting this within 3-4 years. Of course, in just like we are having petrol pumps, same charging stations and infrastructure of these facilities will be created by these manufacturers. Even some new players will be coming under Made in India concepts. So these market trends, that these electric vehicle battery reductions, car connected cars, battery management system, smart charging, wireless on-the-go charging are the key market trends or technology which have major impact on energy electric vehicle market. These electric cars are known to be very efficient as they consume less energy and have much lower emissions and make them environmental friendly. These electric vehicle sales have increased demand for various components because these components and ancillaries are also having same scope, because when vehicle we are purchasing, then wear and tear is there. There's some components and ancillaries, just like in IC engines vehicles, we are having some components and after sales service, these shops are there, showrooms are there, or companies, same, definitely these are having some potential for parts also, such as batteries, instruments, clusters, infotainment systems, and onboard chargers. Because new developments in luxury, these cars and vehicles, this infotainment is also one of the factors. These batteries are the most important part of any vehicle. And they are also costliest part, hence battery management system is the main brain of this vehicle. And this is the main factor for that, and definitely it is coming with new concepts. Lithium-ion batteries and other batteries, this nanotechnology is functioning on that, and definitely some promising results will be coming. Oh, even government of India, they have made this domestic manufacturing push for EV components. This Ministry of Heavy Industries and Public Enterprises, MIPE, issued a notification to all the testing agencies under this faster adoption and manufacturing of electric vehicles in India, that is FAME II. Under this policy, they have made this notification to cover the eligibility under the revised phase manufacturing program for, that is XEV, means it is the generic name for electromotive vehicles, such as hybrid electric vehicles, plug-in hybrid vehicles and full cell electric vehicles. And under this scheme, this is for 5 years, FAME II, and valid up to next 2024 and promotes domestic production across the EV value chain. This notification specifies that all other parts and components other than mentioned above should be domestically manufactured and assembled. Because Government of India is working under this Made in India concept, and FDI is coming now. So hence, this is one of the promising area in which EV technology and EV components and EV parts, definitely Government of India is working under that FAME II notification. This Ministry of Heavy Industries and Plant Enterprise extended this effective date of XEV parts from 1st April 2022 onwards. Now, even Ministry of Road Transport and Highway, that is MoRTH, announced that all the states and union territories are allowed to register and sell EVs without pre-fitted batteries. The move is intended to boost the wider adoption of EV in the country. The prototype of electric vehicles and battery types have to be authorized by the test agencies, according to Central Motor Vehicle Goods. Now, this FAME II program for EVs, gensets, this government has also extended the validity of FAME. And FAME is part of National Electricity Mobility Mission Plan, plans to provide the push for early adoption and market creation for both hybrid and EVs. This FAME program covers all vehicles, two-wheelers, three-wheelers, four-wheelers and buses also. The incentives to be provided are based on the type and make of the any given vehicle. Of course, according to that, incentives are given. This program is expanded version of FAME I, which was launched in 1st April 2015, with total outlay of that at time Indian rupees 8.95 billion. That is, in dollar terms, it is 126.2 million rupees. It was there. Now, Government of India have made that FAME II, and even this Government of Delhi or in Union Territories, they have made in last year, Government Department of Heavy Industries approved that 2636 vehicle charging stations in 62 cities across 24 Indian states and UTs under the second phase of this program, and they have given the permission to this. Now, even government releases incentives for 7,000 e-buses, 55,000 e-cars and 1 million two-wheelers. Government of India have provided demand incentive of rupees 950 million towards 27,201 electric vehicles until last September. The demand incentives will cover 7,000 electric buses, 55,000 electric cars and 1 million electric two-wheelers under FAME. Even 5595 electric buses have been approved for several states and city transport undertakings under FAME program. So under FAME 1, the department has allocated 425 electric and hybrid buses. And under this FAME 2, the government has made a budgetary allocation of rupees 6.93 billion. Or in US dollar, we are finding that 94.17 million for this financial year. Even Delhi and Telangana government have exempted road tax for EVs. Delhi government has exempted road tax on all battery electric vehicles. The transport department issued notification saying that Delhi government has exempted on this as per the Delhi Motor Vehicle Taxation Act 1962. In last August, the government introduced the Delhi Electric Vehicle Policy to enhance the EV adoption in National Capital Region. A new policy proposed tax waive charging and swapping infrastructure establishment, battery cycling ecosystem and creating a non-lapsable state EV fund. They have made that special provision even for battery recycling, because this will be new one challenge for this battery waste disposal, and this will be technical problem, but plus other side of the coin, I think in entrepreneurship term, this will be new opportunity for battery waste management for us, for engineers. Of course, after some use, it will be we have to throw. After its life, we have to throw that battery, but we can recycle that, or at least we can not throw all in on this earth or in water or on soil. We have to make some parts, because this is carrying lithium iron battery and some means ecologic disturbing chemicals are there, and this we should protect them. Hence, battery recycling, battery waste recycling is a new emerging area for us, and definitely it will be having some incentives also. This the government also offered financial incentives for EV wires in the reserve, and is they also planned, even the Telangana government have released its electric vehicles and energy storage policy for 2022 to 2030, announcing subsidies, policy measures, other incentives to turn the state into EV and energy storage system development and manufacturing hub. Government of Telangana is working on that. Of course, Telangana government is having IT hub. Now they are also working on electric vehicle and energy storage policy, so that they will be making that state as the hub, manufacturing and development hub. This new policy will be applicable for 10 years and provides framework to boost the EV adoption, charging infrastructure development and component manufacturing. Under this policy, first 2 lakh electric two-wheelers, 20,000 electrical three-wheelers, 5,000 electric four-wheelers, commercial vehicles, and 10,000 electric three-wheeler goods e-carriers, and 5,000 private electric four-wheelers, and 500 electric buses and electric tractors would be eligible for 100% exemption on road tax and registration fees. So this is their Telangana government policy. Now even electrical two-wheelers can operate as taxis. Government is working on that. They can be offered now in taxis. According to new motor vehicle aggregator guidelines, the government will allow two-wheelers running on electricity or alternative fuels, bioethanol, just like that. Or nowadays methanol is added, ethanol is added, and 10% ethanol it is now added in petrol officially. This ethanol is collected or manufactured from sugar molasses, from sugar mills and sugar cane. And we are this 10% ethanol, this is officially permitted, and on every petrol pump it is written there 10% blending of ethanol in that particular petrol. The government is working on this bioethanol also. Even nowadays methanol is also added, up to 15% methanol blending is giving promising results. Means government is working on both sides, green fuels plus electric vehicles. According to this new guidelines, the state governments would facilitate the implementation of this move. The Ministry of Road Transport and Highways have also exempted electric vehicles running on ethanol and methanol from permit requirements. Even they have made no any permission or no any formalities. Just you prove you are working on this blending of this way, these fuels, green fuels. This increased focus on electric mobility and expects intelligent mobility slowly becoming part of India's strategy for sustainability. Now these are the some of the charging stations. That is, of course, these are from developed countries, but here we are finding, just when you are in office or in parking, you plug in that, and after four or five hours, this will be recharged fully, and we can run this vehicle up to 500 kilometers. And after 500 kilometers, we can again recharge. So these are the some of these charging locations in which electric vehicle. And this is even Tata Power, means it is in India. And its number is also MH15. Means it is of Nasik. MH15 is of Nasik, Maharashtra. And Tata Power, this is powered by Tata Power, and they are offering that services here, electric cars, charging stations. Even these are the assembly of electrical car, what are the components and how it is working. This is the now from my side. It is okay. Now from your side, any questions, welcome. Of course, PPTs will be shared to you. I am seeing in this in chat box, and definitely I will be sharing this. I am sending this to Shri Bibin sir, coordinator of this FDP, and definitely they will be sharing with you, because it is one of the condition of Atal AICT, Atal FDP, ki you have to provide these learning materials to participants. Definitely, they will be sharing you, but this will be in the last. On the last date, you will be getting, all of you will be getting these PPTs of all expert lectures. And definitely, I am going to give them to organizers and they will be sharing with you. Or my mobile and email is with them. Anybody is having any query or any suggestion, welcome. Or suppose due to some time constraint, if anybody is not having, or after that, definitely we can have interaction. My mobile number, WhatsApp number, email is with Bivin sir. So you can take that. But my request to all of attending participants is please think on this new emerging technology, because this is giving promising results. And throughout the world, we are finding new developments, new, all governments, they are working on that. They are providing that incentives. Of course, incentives is the main prime motivation, so that people should attract in that. But when this will be on commercial state, and after, definitely these incentives might be waived off. But utilize that technology. If we are not using this vehicle, at least work on these projects, guide our students in UG, PG projects, PhD work, and submit some good patents, offer some prototypes, make some prototypes, have MOU with these manufacturers, and definitely we'll be working on that. Because government of India and throughout the world, we are known, intellect teachers are the intellect. Of course, majority of the participants, if I'm not wrong, all are teachers. All teachers are almost of AICT is recognized institutes. Since they are of technical backgrounds. So we should work on that. Just we have to give some imbibe, some ignite this innovation culture. Ki this is there and students will be working on that. Definitely when we are going inside, definitely we will be finding some new technology, new developments. World is so fast that the technology is so fast. Even in India, we have seen that Tata Motors, they are also offering some other projects, or even government of India is working on that. They are providing some developments in that. And nanotechnology is so promising, giving promising results in battery life and plus battery materials plus lightweight materials. Main challenge here is the weight of the vehicle. We should work on that under nanotechnology, provide some concepts or some alternative materials can be recharged, materials can be rechargeable, batteries can be there. Even these battery, those who will be used, and beyond repair batteries, we can reuse, recycle that. And again, we can use for either for this recharge or for any other purpose. So we should also explore these waste management aspects also. Yes, from my side, it is okay. Now, from your side, any suggestions?
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Dr. Ashok Matani, sir, for this beautiful session. And one of the participants, Mr. Mohan Kalayappan, asked about what are the EV projects handled in your institute, sir?
Sir, this on this aspect, frankly speaking, in my of this MTech student, they are not working at present, but definitely next batch when they will be entering, because of this year admissions are going to go on in MTech level and PhD under AICT NDF. So definitely I will be encouraging and making them compulsory to work on these projects only, EV projects. Because they have selected the project which is working on waste management of currency waste. One of my PhD scholar is working on currency waste management. And he's working at Navsari Agriculture Institute. And we are going to Konur, in which NIPL, WIPL plant is there, which is working on that waste management, currency waste management, particularly currency waste management. And we are using this currency waste blending with banana fiber, and we are working on that. So definitely this electric vehicle, it will be taken in next batch. Because under me, we are having only one or two students, because we are having good number of MTech and qualified faculty, and we are distributed one or two students every batch. But definitely I will be working for this project. I will be guiding my students, compelling them ki you should work on that.
Thank you, sir. And let me take my time to brief this session. And you have started with the categories of electric vehicle and its components and the market dynamics, especially that it is the cost of EV batteries and EV opportunities all around the world and the world countries' provisions related to the electric vehicle infrastructure creation and the projected market share and a lot more. Thank you for the great session, sir. And on behalf of RMK College of Engineering and Technology, especially from the overall coordinator of this STT FDP, Dr. Bibin sir. So we thank you for accepted our invitation and shared the required information on EV technology, sir. Thank you so much.